Dia mulai berasa hopeless.
He felt hopeless.
Doa enggak terjawab.
He prayed but he didn't got answer.
Sampai satu saat ketika dia putuskan mau tinggalkan Tuhan.
But one time when he decided he was going to leave God,
tiba-tiba ketika dia bersihkan kamar itu WC, itu kerjanya begitu di penjara, dia bersihkan WC.
Suddenly when he was cleaning up all the toilet in the jail.
Dia sebagian orang bidang dipekerjakan membersih toilet.
Because he was a convict.
Yeah, convict.
Yeah. So he was assigned to clean up the toilets.
Dan tahu nggak Bapak Ibu?
Do you know, brother and sister?
Di situ dia menemukan sekumpulan kertas yang ada dekat toilet itu.
He found a pack of papers.
Dan karena dia cleaner, dia ambil.
Because he was the cleaner, he took the papers.
Ada tulisan bahasa Inggris.
And the papers were written in English.
Dia suka bahasa Inggris.
He actually loved English.
Dia buka itu kertas.
He opened the paper.
Maaf Bapak Ibu.
Sorry brother and sister.
Itu kertas.
That paper.
Itu potongan Alkitab yang disobek.
That's a piece of the Bible who is get torn off.
Maaf sekali lagi maaf.
I'm sorry people.
Itu buat cepok.
That Bible piece actually for toilet paper.
Saudara bisa bayangkan.
You can imagine. He just picked it.
Ternyata itu scripture.
It apparently was scripture.
Dia buka.
He opened it.
Roma 8 berkata.
Rome 8 says.
Ayat 35.
Verse 38.
Siapa yang bisa pisahkan aku dari kasih Allah?
Who can separate me from the God's love?
Pedang, ketelanjangan, kesesakan.
Sword, nakedness, hardship.
Waktu dia dengar ayat itu.
When he heard that.
Dia seperti di tempat orang kudus.
He seems like he is lifted by Holy Spirit.
Yeah, as if he convicted by Holy Spirit.
As if like he convicted.
Tahu nggak? Di convict sama Holy Spirit sampai dia tuh tiba-tiba sadar gitu. Aku mau tinggalkan Tuhan nih.
He felt convicted by Holy Spirit and he realized, oh no, I was going to leave God.
Dan sejak itu dia datang ke WC pasti cari kumpulan kertas lagi.
Ever since every time he went to the toilet, he always looking for
dia buka lagi.
Papers. And he opened again.
Dia baca lagi.
And he read again.
Dan pengharapan jadi kuat lagi.
And his hope again. Hallelujah.
Dan tahu nggak Bapak Ibu ketika orang punya pengharapan kuat?
And do you know when someone have a very true hope?
Tiba-tiba.
Suddenly.
Perang Vietnam selesai.
The war Vietnam war finished.
Dan salah satu dikeluarkan dari penjara itu him.
And one of the person that came out from the jail was him.
Dan tahu nggak Bapak Ibu?
And do you know?
Dia kepingin keluar dari Vietnam.
He wanted to get out from Vietnam.
Dia dengan teman-temannya bikin perahu.
And he together with his friend he made a boat.
Dan dia mau pergi ke Pulau Galang.
He went to go to the island Galang.
Di dekat Batam ya.
Near Batam Island.
Dan tahu nggak Bapak Ibu ketika dia mau berangkat?
Do you know when he was about to go?
Tiga polisi datang.
Three police came to him.
Polisinya bilang kamu mau minggat ya?
The police asked him, do you wanna leave the country?
Nah ini perhatikan.
Listen.
Orang Kristen kadang-kadang boleh kecetit seperti itu kadang-kadang keluar jurus mautnya.
A Christian sometimes if he is oppressed, sometimes he got a tricky way.
Bilang sama saya, bohong.
Please say together with me, lying.
Apa?
Lying.
Ayah yang Indonesia yang keras dong. Bohong.
Lying.
Apa?
Lying.
Bohong.
To lie.
Enggak, aku enggak minat kok.
He said no, I wasn't going to leave the country.
Coba buat boat.
I just try to make a boat.
Nanti dijual.
Because I want to sell the boat.
Terus polisnya, oh gitu ya.
And the police say, oh really?
Polisnya pergi.
And the police went.
Tapi orang kurus bicara kepada dia.
But the Holy Spirit talked to him.
Kamu bohong.
You are lying.
Apa? Apa baru kudus?
What?
Bohong.
Lying.
Langsung dia sadar.
Then he repent.
Datang ke polisi. Maaf, saya bohong.
And he actually came to the police officer and said, excuse me, I'm sorry, I lied to you.
Bilang apa?
Lying.
Jadi saya bilang gini, oh kamu bohong.
And the police say, oh you lying.
Jadi kamu mau minggat.
So you wanna leave the country?
Aku juga mau minggat.
Make me
yuk saya yang
asal ikut bawa ke Pulau Galang.
Let me with you in the boat so I can row the boat to go to Galang Island.
Dia tidak punya pengalaman, dia bukan nelayan bisa bawa boat ke Pulau Galang. Vietnam ke Galang itu jauh banget.
He was not a professional sailor, so someone overheard him to row the boat to go to Galang Island, and it was very far away.
Bilang kiri kanan, jangan.
Tell your neighbor and say, don't lie.
Lagi mulai kiri kanan,
don't lie.
Bisa,
Melissa? Don't lie.
Dia tak ngerti, dia tak ngerti.
This person not really understand.
Bisa menangkap Bapak Ibu?
Do you get it, everyone?
Nah, jadi kadang Tuhan izinkan masuk kesesakan.
Sometimes God allow you to experience hardship.
Tapi percaya, kalau kita harap pada Tuhan.
But believe, if you have hope to God.
Waktunya akan tiba.
The time has will come.
Anda akan menerima janji Tuhan.
You will experience the promise of God.
Sekali lagi yang percaya beramai. Amin. Nah, sekarang pada ayat kelima, perhatikan.
The fifth one.
Ayat kelima saya baca dalam bahasa Indonesia. Put just put out in English, please. Saya baca dalam Indonesia, dikatakan begini. Dan pengharapan tidak mengecewakan karena kasih Allah telah dicurahkan dalam hati kita oleh Roh Kudus yang telah dikaruniakan kepada kita. Berarti apparently you need to read in English.
Okay. And hope does not put us to shame because God's love has been poured into our heart.
Perhatikan nih, ketika event kita ini ada Chinese New Year, ada Valentine.
Today our event is Chinese New Year and Valentine's.
Saya berdoa Tuhan ayat scripture apa yang cocok untuk bisa match up between these two events.
I pray to God what which scripture that can match two events together.
Tuhan ingatkan ayat ini.
God remind me of this verse.
Ternyata ada hubungannya love and hope.
Apparently there is a connection between love and hope.
Saya yakinkan Bapak Ibu, Anda tidak mungkin bisa punya pengharapan kuat.
I convince you that you will not have a true hope
tanpa mau merenungkan betapa dalamnya kasih Allah dalam hidup kita.
Without thinking how deep is God's love in your life.
Yang setuju dengan Anda.
If you agree, say amen.
Tidak mungkin saya harap kepada seseorang yang saya anggap jahat.
Impossible I put my hope what I consider someone so evil.
Percaya?
Do you believe?
Datang ke Indonesia.
You go to Indo.
Masuk ke daerah preman.
Go to the area that is full of
criminals. Kalau Anda datang ke situ.
If you go there.
Tidak mungkin dong kalau ada orang bawa belati besar begitu ya, lagi nodong-nodongin orang.
You saw someone with a big like a sword and this someone like a scam people. Give me your money.
Terus kata, saya Tuhan.
And you come to this person and you say, I'm the child of God.
Saya ke gereja setiap hari.
I go to church every day.
Kasih duit dong.
Just give me money.
Kira-kira diapain sama itu orang?
Do you think, what do you think this person will do to you?
Ditodong balik.
He will of course point the sword to you.
Nggak mungkin Bapak Ibu tuh harap kepada orang yang jahat.
It's impossible if you put your hope in the evil person.
Makanya kalau kita ngerti kasih Allah dalam hidup kita.
Therefore, if you understand God's love in your life.
Mudah bagi kita untuk harap kepada Dia.
It's easier for us to put our hope in God.
Yang percaya bilang amin.
If you believe, say amen.
Ketika kita merenungkan kasih Allah.
When we meditate God's love.
Dua hal kita alami.
You will experience two things.
Yang pertama.
The first one.
Saudara percaya bahwa saudara pribadi dikasih Tuhan.
You believe that you are a person that loved by God.
Siapa yang percaya, lambaikan tangan.
Who believe? Raise
siapa yang percaya kalau kamu dikasih Tuhan.
Who believe that you are loved by God?
Kalau kita percaya, Bapak Ibu.
If you believe.
Apapun yang diizinkan mau terjadi.
Everything that God allowed to happen.
Tidak akan pernah patahkan hope kita.
It will not destroy your hope.
Yang percaya bilang apa?
If you believe, say amen.
Ada seorang ibu yang ditinggal meninggal oleh suaminya.
One lady who was a widow, the husband passed away.
dan dia harus besarkan anaknya yang masih kecil 2 tahun.
She had to raise her child which was only 2 years old.
Sulit Bapak Ibu.
It's very hard.
Dia harus besarkan anak, dia harus bekerja, banting tulang.
She has to raise the child, she has to work.
Titipkan anak ke orang lain, dia harus bayar.
He asked someone to take care of the child and she has to pay that person to take care of her child.
Dia banting tulang kerjanya.
She worked very hard.
Sampai
until
ibu ini sakit-sakitan.
This lady got ill.
Yeah. Dan ibu ini kelihatan tua gitu loh.
And this lady became look old.
Gak seperti usianya.
Older than what she supposed to be.
Anaknya growing kan, jadi anak yang remaja sekarang.
And the child grew and now become teenager.
16 tahun.
16 years old.
Waktu pesta-pesta kalau yang lain bawa orang tua.
If the party, if everyone brought parents.
Anak ini malu akuinnya adalah mamanya dia.
The child actually embarrassed to bring her mom, his mom.
Siapa itu?
And then people ask, who is that lady?
Mantu saya.
And this child actually said, that's my maid.
Tahu Bapak Ibu, ibu itu hancur hatinya.
Do you know the mother's heart broken?
Bapak Ibu ini sudah habis-habis menasihat.
She already worked very hard to love this child.
Anaknya lupakan ibunya.
But the child forget about the mom.
Satu saat anaknya sakit.
One day the child got sick.
Sakit keras.
Very bad illness.
Yeah,
terminal illness.
Benar-benar dia sakit.
Really, he was sick.
Ibunya jual rumahnya.
The mother sold her house.
Dan dia harus kerja lebih keras lagi.
And she had to work harder and harder.
Bayar rumah sakit.
To pay for the hospital fees.
Dan kerjanya lebih keras lagi.
And she worked very hard, harder than before.
Sementara anaknya tambah lama tambah baik, membaik.
And the child is getting better.
Ibunya tambah lama tambah menurun kesehatannya.
And the mother is getting sick, getting deteriorating. The health is deteriorating.
Anaknya sembuh.
And the child healed.
Ibunya mati.
The mother passed away.
Dan ketika anak itu tahu ibunya meninggal.
But when the child find out that the mom passed away,
baru dia menyesal Bapak Ibu.
Then he regretted himself.
Karena selama ini tidak pernah merenungkan kasih ibunya.
Because he never meditated his mom's love.
Tahu nggak Bapak Ibu, Tuhan mengasihi kita.
Do you know that God love us?
Hidup berikan segalanya buat kita.
He gave everything to us.
Masa sih kita ragu bahwa Tuhan itu nggak baik sama kita?
And we have to doubt God's love, that God is not good for
coba
us.
Coba renungkan Bapak Ibu, di tengah susahmu sendirian pun.
Please think and meditate in your heart.
Siapa tengah malam yang datang untuk kamu?
Who will come to you to attend for you when you are sick in the night? Everyone else will not come to
anggota
attend
keluarga you. Mungkin tidur.
Maybe another family just they went to sleep.
Tapi Tuhan datang.
But God will come to you.
Anakku.
And he said, my child.
Ini aku buat kamu.
This is me for you.
Yo Bapak Ibu.
Brother and sister.
Jangan harap kau kasih Tuhan.
Please put our hope in God's love.
Tidak peduli rupa Bapak Ibu kayak apa.
Doesn't matter what you look like.
Bapak Ibu dikasih Tuhan.
You are loved by God.
Jadi kalau kita merenungkan kasih Tuhan,
we meditate God's love.
Kita tahu.
We know.
Kita merenungkan kasih Tuhan.
We are loved by God.
Yang kedua terakhir.
The second one, the last one.
Kalau kita renungkan kasih Tuhan,
we meditate God's love.
Kita alami.
We will experience
resources dari Tuhan.
Resources from God.
Yang percaya bilang amin.
If you believe say amen.
Di sini ada beberapa keluarga.
In here there are a few families.
Dan juga ada beberapa yang saya kenal.
And also someone that I know.
Rumahnya banyak.
He or she owns lots of properties.
Ada yang rumahnya bisa 10 rumah loh, bayangin.
One person own 10 properties, 10 houses.
Saya kasih tahu Bapak Ibu.
I tell you brother and sister.
Ujung-ujungnya rumah itu tuh siapa?
At the end, who are those properties for?
Kasih tahu untuk siapa?
Tell me for who.
Loh, kok dia itu siapa?
For who?
Anaknya.
For his or her children.
Kalau saya jadi adopsi, diadopsi jadi anaknya.
If I get adopted become his, one of his children.
Saya dapat rumah.
I will get one house.
Jadi bapak mama itu nggak mungkin memberikan jelek buat anak-anaknya.
So parents will not give something bad to his children.
Bapak mama selalu sediakan resources terbesar buat anak-anak.
Father and mother. father always provide a good, best resources for children.
Hari ini sebelum kita pulang,
before we go home,
percaya,
believe,
Tuhan sediakan resources buat kita.
God will provide that those resources for you.
Dia penuhi segala kebutuhan kita bahkan lebih daripada yang kita pikirkan.
He shall supply all your need more than whatever you can think.
Yang percaya bilang amin. Hari ini kita belajar hope and love.
Today we talk about hope, harap dan kasih.
Kita percaya, kita harap pada Tuhan karena kita tahu Allah mengasihi kita.
We believe that we put our hope in God because we know that God loves us.
Kalau Tuhan sudah buat baik buat kita,
if God already do good to you,
sudah saatnya juga kita buat buat others.
It's time for us to do good for others.
Joy.
Joy.
Jesus, others, and yourself.
Jesus, others, and yourself.
Kalau Anda percaya bahwa engkau seperti pribadi dikasih Tuhan,
if you believe that you are loved by God,
Tuhan ingin kita connect each other.
God wants us to connect together.
Yang percaya bilang amin.
If you believe,
biar kita berdiri sama-sama.
Let's stand up together.
Biar apa yang disampaikan Pastor Gigi, Pastor Megan, dan saya hari ini berdiri berkat buat Bapak Ibu sekalian. Saya minta musik di sana.
The word of God which is preached by Pastor Gigi, Pastor Megan, and Pastor Johan will be blessing to all of you.
Tadi ada lagu, tadi saya
lihat rada-rada yang berbau Mandarin.
There was a song with a Chinese lyrics.
Itu kalau nyanyikan Tuhan memberiku nyanyian baru.
God gave me a new song.